Hey all, welcome back for Ocarina of Time. Here we are, about to head into the Spirit Temple. The Kid Link side, at least. This is Idrin.
This is Roxy.
And this is Abby.
And let's go ahead and talk to Nabooru again before we run in. Just to catch things up, she's asked us to pull the silver gauntlets out of here so she can go ahead and rob this temple blind and get in the way of Ganondorf.
Nice. You know what? Aiding and abetting? Nice.
Nice.
Yep. She's good people.
I see the first room is just setting up sort of expectations for us.
Yep. And it's doing it pretty well, too. And unfortunately, because we're Kid Link, we're stuck with a few of the older, weaker items. So we've got to be a little bit careful going through this one. And I'm going to see if I can take care of that Armus without waking it up.
Oh boy. Can you read the thing on the mural behind it?
I'll see once I finish this. That kind of worked.
Hmm.
Let's see. Unfortunately, doesn't look like it. Oh. It's nice to see what I assume is Gerudo writing, though. It's very neat letter forms.
Mm.
You can also, in this case, see kind of the text trick that Zelda often did with its images, where it's just the same image on the left and right, just smeared across, and on the top and bottom as well. Just single panel that's shown four times.
Yeah.
Did that a lot for the bigger ones. Yep.
Doors to the left of me, doors to the right. Oh, we can open those. Okay.
Let's go ahead and open this with this mysterious puzzle. Oh. Okay. That was kind of a clever trick.
These fuckers.
I just turned all those into fire keys.
You played yourself.
That was mean, but I liked it. I didn't even know that they could do that. Almost missed that.
Hmm.
You destroyed.
Good that the boomerang just sort of goes through walls there.
It's a magic boomerang.
Yep. It is a magic boomerang.
Now we get to fight a Stalfos as Kid Link. Maybe I can stun him. Maybe that'll make it a little easier. Nope.
No dice.
Gotta brush up on those sword skills.
Yep. Also, I'm going to do this so I can actually move around while I'm blocking. Just want to make sure to put it back away before I go into somewhere else with fire.
I was just going to ask, if one of those bubble skull things hit your shield, would it burn?
I'm not actually sure. That's a good question. I think it does for the red ones, but for the others...
But not for, like, the others, right?
I'm not sure. It might.
That's what I thought, too.
Also, that green one over there is a giant. Dang.
Yep, we ran into one of those underneath the well back from getting the wand of truth.
Mm.
head out this whole time and forgot about that. Should have done that earlier. Oh well.
Just hit him with a stick.
I guess you really stuck it to him there. It wasn't even that good, but thanks guys for humoring me.
You know I love bad jokes.
Yes. That's what I'm here for.
It's a fast one. Maybe the boomerang will work better. Kind of.
We stunned it.
Yeah, maybe I can finish it off now.
Maybe that could give you enough time to, like, jump across, or...
Oh.
Oh, no, wait, you can't. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
I forgot that the bridge was up.
Yeah. Maybe I can stun it when it's above, and then I can just slingshot it down.
Ooh. Perfect.
Oh, only one shot.
Nice.
Now to get this bridge down. Oh, right.
Go to the side.
Yeah. I'm used to the arc from, I think, Wind Waker, where it does curve out. When it does curve out when you throw it.
Haunted pots?
Yeah. Oh.
The pot's revenge.
Thanks, treasure chest.
Oh, you just switch out your shield.
Oh, yeah, thank you. That could have been bad. Oh, and it's a very good room to do that, because here we've got a new enemy.
Mm. Ooh.
Oh, I love these guys.
Yeah. Flying, fire-breathing mummies.
Nice.
Gonna sit here so I can see the fire again. It'll actually...
Oh, he's camera shy.
Makes sense.
Maybe if you don't Z-target him?
Yeah, or maybe it's because I was protecting myself. I'm just gonna get the fire out to be ready. No, I think you were right, Roxy. Just
I think...
Oh, I see what you were supposed to do. Okay.
So what are you saying?
Oh, I was gonna say, I think if I remember correctly, this temple uses a lot of the Eye of Truth. The Lens of Truth thing.
That's a good point. So let me see if there's something like that here, because I think I get the gimmick of what you were supposed to do against that guy instead of using Dense Fire. You're supposed to make that light appear. It doesn't look like it's in this particular room, though. But you're supposed to make that fire appear and then use the fact that he keeps away from you to maneuver him into that fire.
Yeah.
But just burning him is easier.
I mean, you have your own magic. You're powerful.
Yep.
Oh, no.
Assholes. Yep.
Honestly, they're not bad.
They're just assholes.
Mm-hmm. Just gonna take it out now. Also, free money.
You know what they say about free money?
What do they say, Andy?
You pay interest tax
Take
anyways?
It.
Oh. I almost legitimately missed that one.
Mm-hmm.
there's a bridge.
Oh, hey. Now those fire keys can get through.
Oh, yes, they can.
Eh, they're fine.
Well, I literally jumped from that.
There you go.
Okay. I was gonna grab this chest. I don't think there's anything else to get in this room. Well, some hearts, I guess. Because I can definitely use those.
Mmm. Delicious. I got one. Geese heart.
Good enough for me. Geese heart. It's a rare delicacy in Hyrule.
You're not going to cross the bridge?
Well, that just leads back to where I was. Where I was before, where I made that chest appear.
Oh, okay.
Yep, that's just the other side of that room.
This asshole's back.
And more annoying now because of the bridge. So I'm just gonna run through and run past that Stalfos too. We got a key now though. I believe we need that key for in here. Yep.
Nut boxes.
I was hoping for some more hearts, but oh well.
Hey Roxy, do you think we should get a boomerang to take care of spiders?
No.
I don't know. It's
that's
fun.
As dry as an answer you're gonna get from me. No, we don't have obviously a giant spider problem like this. To need a boomerang.
Yeah, thankfully there aren't all that many Skulltulas in the UK.
But we got a tiny boomerang though.
A teeny tiny one that's like hamster sized, sure.
Yeah.
Oh. Respect to Lizalfos.
Honestly, I think Lizalfos are one of my favorite enemies.
I love their sounds. They're so cute.
They are, actually. Then they do the little flip. And when they go to like strike you, they do like a nice lunge forward.
Yeah.
They make a comeback. Or they're reasonably prominent in Breath of the Wild, from what I've seen.
Oh, nice. I need to get to that game.
I remember they're in Wind Waker.
I don't remember them in Wind Waker. Where...
Or maybe a lizard type in Wind Waker.
I'm trying to remember lizard enemies. I'm sure I'm just forgetting them. Let's open that up and see why that's blinking.
Bomchu, why?
Oh, why the frick did I say Wind Waker? Twilight Princess.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
I remember them.
Yeah, I remember their design, and for some reason it says Wind Waker.
Where did this guy come from? Another one? Oh.
He came from the ceiling.
Uh-huh.
There we go.
Man, sticks are powerful.
Yep. Stick by itself, I think, is, if you're just swinging it normally, is twice as powerful as a Kokiri sword, and a jumping attack is twice as powerful as that. Mm. I'm going to stop fiddling with bomb juice for this one. I'm going to try just using a normal bomb. That didn't work.
I think normal bombs might actually be harder.
Yeah, so let's go back to bomb juice and try just lining myself up. There we go.
Hey.
And here we see the first big gimmick of the Spirit Temple.
Creepy sons.
Exactly. wonder if this switch was actually relevant to the puzzle.
No, of course not
at all. Yeah, they're kind of hinting that way.
Yep.
They're like, oh well, bomb chews for this this puzzle.
Bomb chews are fun. I'm not too upset.
There are the second best chews.
What's the best chew, Ambie?
Pikachu.
Oh, I was thinking Charleston.
Eh.
Where is that gold sculpture? I can hear it. Maybe it's down this big hole. Wait, no, that's the way we came up.
It does sound close to here, though.
Yeah.
Like, close to the big hole, maybe.
Oh, or wait, maybe I'm dumb and the spiders just respawned down here. Oh, never mind. Fourteen left.
Dang. That's a lot of tokens.
Yep.
A whole lot of dead spiders. Ooh. What's the big statue in the center?
That's an Armus there, but then we've also got this one, which is probably the one you're more talking about.
Yes. Whoa.
Ah, yes.
Nice.
Her. So, Adrian, I think I've talked to you about the statue before.
Maybe. Okay. We talked about the one outside the temple.
No, I... When I was... Okay. It kind of ties into Twilight Princess, but I won't bring it up until later.
Oh, you can go ahead and bring it up now, unless you mean it's spoilers for later in this game.
It's spoilers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wait, I don't know why I'm playing Scarecrow's song here, because it won't even work. even if it did work, I don't have the hook shot, so. Let's see if I can remember what it is you actually do.
You die.
Well, yeah, probably eventually. I mean, you know me. Okay. That was easier than I thought. Well, let's do some exploring. Didn't get me that time. I love the trap enemies. The pots, the fake doors, the... fake floors sometimes. They're fun.
I think it's a nice little bit of, like, flavor for the game.
Yeah. A big chest.
Is this the silver ones?
It's almost as good.
I don't think so.
Let's take a look at the map, since Roxy pointed out before, I don't look at this often enough lately. It's a nice sized temple. We've explored a good bit of it so far.
And quite nicely laid out.
Yeah. Oh, we can't actually get up on that side right now. And that door is locked, so let's just head up to that door that we did open. going to be a little bit tricky with Silver Rupee Room. And I feel like this might be somewhere where the Lens of Truth will be needed. So let me just give a quick look around with it. Maybe not. Don't see anything.
Might just be very straightforward.
Yeah.
There are a lot of torches, though.
Oh, that is true. So I bet this is going to be a torch run.
Man, bomb trees are the best.
It's a lot of Beamos in here. I'm glad you can actually destroy them in this game. I think you can in most games lately, can't you, Roxy?
The what?
The Beamos. The...
Because
I know you couldn't in Link of the Past, but I think in most other games you can.
Yeah. Mm. Pretty sure.
It's always satisfying to blow them up.
My instinct whenever I see them is to just try to blow them up.
Yeah.
One end out?
I think explosions. They've been... Yeah, and I think they've been in, like, every Zelda game?
I don't think they were in the early ones, but I think every Zelda game tends to Link to the Past, at least. I haven't actually played the NES ones much, though.
Yeah,
so.
Like, A Link to the Past, I think Link's Awakening, and then all the other games since then.
Yep. Nice job, Link. So, I have to ask, how nice is it in Breath of the Wild actually being able to control Link's jumps?
We don't have Breath of the Wild.
Oh, I thought you did.
No, okay. That's just Ambi trying to show that he's cool.
Oh, okay. Nice try, Ambi.
Some gameplay.
I've not spoiled myself at all by avoiding the gameplay.
Ooh, fire.
Okay. Alright, get your stick out and run.
Yep. Just kind of map out in my head where all the torches are right now. So you've got there, there. Can't only be those two. Pretty sure there's one more. Where is it? Yep, over there in the corner. Okay. Let's see, which way do I want to go at this? I'll try it this way. I was over here. Oh no, it's around this corner. I was too slow. Yep. Okay.
I think it's clockwise in them.
Didn't mean to do that. I'm gonna switch those around because I'm used to having sticks in the left C position. And yeah, I think you're right, Roxy. So let's
clockwise. Flip it, turn ways.
God, the Homestuck jokes in 2018 are still good.
Yeah. I'll never die.
I think you just missed one.
There we go. Thankfully, I did not.
Yeah, okay.
Speedfire.
Speedfire is the best fire.
What about super hot fire?
I mean, those are basically the same thing, if you think about it.
Okay.
Yep. And now the third puzzle in here to pull that sun block over into that beam of light.
Three puzzles, one room. Can you Habib it?
I like how this is a puzzle.
Yeah. The context-sensitive controls are neat and also very annoying sometimes. Just to explain it for you, Amber, if you push into the block, it swaps to climb. So if you're moving towards the block and trying to grab it, then a lot of the time you'll just jump onto it, like I kept doing there.
Yeah.
The sun. He wake.
Now, if I can remember which one of these doors is actually the entrance and which was the exit. I think this one was the exit. Yes, it was. Okay, cool.
Oh, there's a skull to him?
Yep. I think it's... Yep. Figured it'd be behind me, because that's what they usually do.
Nice. I think this is one of the rooms.
Yep, this is one of the rooms.
Okay. Yeah! Fucking get Nabooru's love in there.
Check this out, Ambi.
Ooh. That is probably, like, the fly shit Adrian has ever said. Check this out.
This is a cool-ass enemy.
Iron Knuckle. Love.
I think it's because your sword is so short.
Yeah, so let's give myself a little bit more length.
Oh no. Jesus Christ. Do sticks actually do the same amount of damage as the great sword? As the master sword?
I think so, yeah.
Oh my god.
Taking no chances.
Nope.
I think you gotta be tighter on those rolls, because once he attacks, you have like a second to get back in there and attack.
Oh, he's going down though. Just saw his armor break.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's one of the cool things with this fight, is that like, the more you attack him, the more his armor starts to fall off.
Yep. But also, that means the faster he gets.
Yeah.
Also, I love the pillar explosions.
Yeah, as soon as you walked into the room and I saw the pillars, I was like, oh, this is that. Get those hearts! Adrian, you are a rebel.
He's a saint. He's the salt of the earth. And he's what's her name?
And what I assume is Ganondorf's throne.
Nice. Pretty good throne.
It's bricks. Let's cut the bullshit. He would have a way more ornate throne.
That's true.
Maybe when he's not there, they put the real throne away so that nobody steals it.
I mean, probably.
I mean, because I imagine that would be the ultimate dishonor. Like, as the King of Thieves, having your throne be stolen?
Use Kibora Gibora again.
Wait, are the Gerudo known as thieves?
Yeah, they've got a reputation for that. Just part of the sucks. Part of the implicit racism in Zelda.
Yeah, that's what I was just gonna say.
Yep.
Isn't Ganondorf referred to that as like one point?
Yeah, that one of his titles is the King of Thieves.
The King of Thieves, yeah.
Yeah.
Also, Kibora Gibora thinking like, oh, so the legends are true of the boy traveling through time or whatever. I'm like, aren't you Raru? Like, wasn't this implied by the game?
Yep. Now that we've actually met him, by the way, Ambi, yeah, Kibora Gibora is Raru projecting himself into the physical world. It was implied here. You'll notice that when he does the head flip, his face actually looks like Raru's face with the eyebrows as a mustache.
Yeah.
And it was stated outright in Hyrule's story to confirm it that, yep, he is Raru.
Nice.
Bye, asshole.
See ya.
What could possibly be in this chest?
I'm sure it's the compass.
Gold.
Nice.
The silver gauntlets.
Ooh. Yep. Unfortunately, Child Link is too tiny to put them on.
Power in your arms.
Oh, and also that. We did promise to give them to Nabooru.
Alternatively, could you wear them on your legs?
The strongest kicks.
The strongest kicks.
Oh. A thing just happened.
Nabooru! Yarr! I wonder if that gave them idea for Majora's Mask, that yarg.
Well, shit.
Nabooru?
Nanny?